cut my hair twice. I freaked out. Hi everyone, this is Faye, and today we're back in my bathroom because I want to show you how I cut my hair at home, and I kind of need a mirror in front of me. It's not hard at all. It's actually very, very simple, and I'll give you two ways of doing it. For one of them, all you need is obviously scissors, and you want it to be sharp, and a hair tie. And for the other option, you will also need a little hair clip like this so you can clip sections of your hair away. So you can either do this when your hair is very, very straight or when you have wet hair. And I just got out of the shower and I kind of need to cut my hair a little bit because the ends are kind of fried up. So that's what I'm gonna do. For the first method, what you can do is what I used to do. You just brush all of your hair to the top of your head, so you turn upside down and then you brush your hair, make sure there's no tangles, and then you tie your hair up at the top of your head. But what I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna section my hair and do that with the top section first, and then I'll cut it off. And then the cutting method is the same for both of them, so I don't have to show you both of them because I can't really show you both of them because I can't cut my hair twice. The sizes of the sections are really, really up to you. I'm gonna do this much first, and then I'm gonna do maybe one or two more. So either I'm gonna cut the whole thing or another section and then another teeny tiny section. I'm gonna put the first section up and I'll show you how that looks like. So two very important things is that you wanna gather it at the top, not at the front of your hair. And when you're upside down, it's kind of like easier to gather it to the front. What happens is when you cut it, the front part is gonna be shorter than the back part. So if it's too much to the front, you're gonna cut too much of the top hair and not as much of this bottom hair. So you want it to be in the middle so it's more even. But it really is depending on what you want to achieve in the end. So it's up to you. And the other thing is when you are tying it up, you wanna make sure that the hair is straight and that you're not twisting it like this, because then it's just gonna look like a hot mess. Make sure your hair is where it should be and not twisted. And yeah, I have a straight hair. I'm gonna have to brush that up again. Excuse me. It's just kind of annoying because with my camera situation right now, I can't really just take it and show you what I'm doing when I turn my head upside down. So I'm very sorry about that, but I'm sure you can figure out what's going on. So I want to do that. So now that you have this 80s ponytail, you just want to make sure that it is brushed and untangled. And what you're gonna do, you're gonna pull it all the way up and then decide how much you want to cut. And this looks like a lot of hair, but it really isn't because my hair is curly. And another thing is that I'm not very sure how this turns out on straight hair because I don't have straight hair. So I know with curly hair, it turns out great because even if it's not completely perfect, my hair is curly, so the curls are gonna hide the imperfections and it's gonna look great. But it's very nice and easy to get layers and beautiful curly hair, but I don't really know how that will be for straight hair. So if you want to try that out, just be extra careful with making sure it's straight so it doesn't look super weird, and then maybe you can send us a picture and see how that looks like. So I'm gonna cut this much hair. Again, you just go up like so, and I'm gonna hold it like this. I'm gonna cut this much hair. Ta-da! Not hard at all. And again, this kind of looks like a lot of hair, but it really isn't. The first time I cut my hair this way, I freaked out. I started cutting it and I was doing the whole bunch at the top, so it looks like even more hair because there's so much hair. And I was like, oh my god, what am I doing? I'm cutting my hair, it's so much hair, it's gonna be so short. And then in the end, it wasn't short at all. It was just that the top layers were now shorter, but the length was still pretty much the same. It was just layered and it looked great. So don't freak out. It looks like more hair than it actually is. So now I'm gonna clip this hair away and I'm gonna put this one up I'm actually not gonna tie it up, I'm just gonna break it up. And I'll show you how that is. Like so, and then I'm gonna brush this to the top, and I'll be right back. So really there isn't much hair left to cut, and I'm just gonna go like this, and try to keep it straight. Okay, I wanna cut this much hair out. I just have to hold it with my other hand, and I'm gonna cut it. There's really so much less hair, it's so much harder to hold it, and I can't really see it, so this much. And there you go. Now there's one more part. I forgot this hair was tied up here. I just do kind of like the front of the hair to frame my face a little bit shorter. I'm just gonna brush my hair back to where it should be. As my hair dries, it gets kind of chaotic because it's, you're not supposed to brush curly hair because it just turns chaotic. So I'm just trying to put it back where it was. I don't know if you can tell, but I can't certainly tell that it is different. There's like shorter layers and I'm already liking it. I will obviously come back and show you how my hair looks like once it's dry. And you will see. It's very nice and curly. Okay, so for the front part, I just get this much hair, like from the front of my ear. Flip this away. Now I brush this. So you see how it's different lengths. So I still want this part to be shorter. This part. And that's what we're gonna do. Okay, so this is the part that would be like my bangs, and this part I want to be shorter. Okay, so when you cut it like this, the part in the center is gonna be a bit shorter than the part on the sides. If you just think that your head is kind of like round like this, you can think that this hair is gonna have to be longer to get here than the hair that is here, right? Because then this hair is shorter because of the top of the curve. So I hope you understand what I'm saying. But yeah, so there, if you think that way, you can figure out how you want your bangs to look like. I just want it a bit shorter because it's too long, obviously. And I'm just gonna cut this much hair. Now just clip this away. And I'm gonna do these sides. This hair is basically dry. It's kind of annoying. You can wet it again if you want. I don't care that much. Again, because my hair is curly, so it doesn't show as much. If there's any imperfections, I don't really care much. So I'm gonna pull this to the front and cut a little bit of hair. Just kind of here. The little bit of hair goes away. Bye hair. There we go. Yeah, so you see how, you can see this here, how this hair is on an angle like that, because this part is going to be shorter than this part, right? So that's what I mean, and I hope you can see it. Alright, so now I'm gonna have to get my hair wet again so I can style it, and I will come back and show you how the final look is. Yay! So this is how my hair turned out, and as you can see, there's no dead ends anymore. The curls go all the way to the bottom, and now I have some layers, and this piece of hair used to go all the way down here, which I don't like because it's supposed to frame my face. So now it's a length that I like, and you can tell that there are different lengths of hairs everywhere. And yeah, I'll just show you in the back how it looks like. So yeah, I'm very happy with the result. I find it super easy to cut my hair, and you know that feeling that you have when you go to the salon and then you feel like your hair feels so much healthier, and that kind of like, you know, when you go through your hair and it ends before you were expecting, it kind of freaks you out. So you can get all of that without expending any money. So it's great. I love cutting my hair at home. And I also know that if I mess up, then I don't have to be angry at anyone, just myself. And I feel like that's a lot better than having to complain at the salon that you hated your hair. So yeah, I've never had a bad experience by cutting my hair this way. So I really recommend you try, because it's really not hard. I just show you, so you know. yeah, I did record a video of this makeup and also a haul video for the makeup that I bought. So I'm gonna leave links here. I think this video is gonna come up before the tutorial, but after the haul. So we'll see. I'll leave links somewhere, probably up here and down in the description box. And that's it. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up and to subscribe so you can get notifications for whenever I have new videos on. And thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye bye.